I have two kids, and they are 7 years old and 11 years old.
19 and 23.
I have one son, he's 4 years old, and I'm pregnant with my second one.
I would say she's smart, Miss Chatterbox, and also she's a bit cheeky at times.
My girls, they are beautiful, they are talented, they can dance very well, and they are very affectionate. They are very loving kids.
It was the growing up, watching them grow and develop, learn, whether it was their first steps on their first day to school or when they graduated from college and in time to come to university. I think that's the best thing about motherhood.
You can be a monster, a She-Hulk, and yet your kids will still love you. They will still go to you at night before they go to bed, and then they will still hug you and say, "Love you, Mom."
I think one of the struggles I have is really lack of personal time, especially when children are young. They're always needing your attention and they always need you to be around. This is before they can be truly, you know, independent and doing their own things. They want you to play with them, to be constantly with them.
The working mom guilt, I feel that I have not enough time given to them to focus on their studies.
I had to come back to work very soon after giving birth. Sometimes it meant that the babies were brought to me during lunchtime, especially when I don't have any appointments. But most of the time, it was about bringing what was known then as the milking machine. And they weren't referring to me, it was a true machine. And looking for a safe, quiet environment where I could express my milk for my children. It was, in a way, embarrassing because people didn't know how to deal with it, but it helped that I was a more mature mother by then, and I had a lot more confidence in myself.
I imagine that it would be a world of opportunities, whether is it education, whether is it the ability to buy a piece of property even for an affordable price, opportunities to experience nature, opportunities to have clean air, opportunities to be able to see some of these animals before they go extinct. I want my child to have opportunities.
I wish that she's doing well in whatever she does and that she need to know that I'm always here to support her, to guide her, to love her, and of course to be kind to others around her.
I wish for them to be happy always, to have wealth, health, intelligence, values, kind-hearted, to help people, to have a happy family, and to also have spiritual growth.
Respect for people and respect for the environment, even respect for people that are different from himself, opposing views. I think I would want him to grow up with that kind of openness and maturity to be able to live in harmony with other people.
I would want them to be wholesome individuals where you can put them in any situation, in any kind of hardships, and they can survive. And they care about the betterment of the world, the betterment of people, more than themselves. They are more selfless than selfish. So that's what I want for my kids.
I wish that my children will learn to count their blessings in years to come, that they would learn hard lessons, but they are lessons that would help them carry on when we are no longer around, and they have good experiences